This is JB from Know the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be trying out the new expansion to Marvel Champions the card game, The Rise of Red Skull. I will be playing with Spider-Woman, Jessica Drew, against Crossbones on standard difficulty. I'm trying out the new campaign rules, so I will be continuing from Crossbones to Absorbing Man, and I will do a separate video where I will be playing against Taskmaster and Zola, and finally in the last video of this series I will be taking on Red Skull with Spider-Woman. So I am using the standard deck that comes with the Rise of Red Skull expansion for Spider-Woman. So it's Aggression Justice, and there are of course the Leadership and Protection aspect cards that double as Spider-Woman cards. So if you're wondering, there they are in the deck because they are part of the Spider-Woman standard set. I won't go over the deck list because it's the one introduced in the Rise of Red Skull booklet for Spider-Woman. One thing to note, Crossbones comes in with this experimental weapons deck, and we flip one card at the start, which is the energy shield. It gives the villain retaliate one, and we can remove it spending on mental and energy resource. So I think we'll try to get rid of that soon. The first main scheme has only three threat thresholds, so it will be a fast one. Let's see how this goes, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. So we get six cards. We get Skillet Investigator, okay, so we want to play it and defeat side schemes. We also get Interrogation Room, a Genius, Energy, Clear the Area. Well, we're not really needing these four cards at the start, so I think I will try to get some aggression cards. I think I'll keep this because I can just play it for free. So we'll keep these, mulligan these two, see what we get. Okay, so we get the Spider Girl and another self-propelled glide, so I think that's okay. Can start. So I think my first action will be to look at the top card of any deck. I'll look at the top card of the encounter deck, so we know. So we know this, that it only has the boost, so I think it's safe to stay in Alter Ego for this turn, because Crossbones only schemes for one and doesn't get the boost for the scheme for this turn. So yeah, I think I'll just set up a bit. So or it doesn't really matter because we're playing Spider Girl, so let's just go the aggression route. So I'll flip and I'll use Genius to play Spider Girl. After you play Spider Girl from your hand, stun and confuse the minion. oh yeah, it's a minion. Read those cards better. Well, there's no minions, so... Okay, so let's back up and just set up. Oh yeah, that is a hero action, so I will... Yeah, let's just start wailing at the crossbones. So I will play an aspect card, and to keep in mind the superhuman agility, interrupt when you play an aspect card, Spider-Woman gets +1/4, +1 attack and +1 defense until the end of the round. Limit once per round for each aspect. So I'll just mark it with that so I can better remember how much boost I have here. So we'll then discard an energy and a mental resource to get rid of this. And these go into the encounter discard pile. If you're wondering where the experimental weapons go, I only have this card in hand. I can't play it, so let's just start hitting. Spider Girl hits for 2 damage, and Spider Woman hits for 2 damage. So we just try to burn down crossbones as fast as possible. I'll keep the self-propelled glide in hand. I'll draw back up to 5. We get a contaminant immunity. Press the advantage, piercing strike, and combat training. Ready up. We go to the villain phase. Crossbone adds 1 threat to the main team. Crossbone attacks. It attacks. I'll take it with Spider Woman. So, as we know, this is the boost card only. So, we take 1 damage. Then so the villain only just attacks us again, but we don't get the boost card for that. The encounter card for this turn is Hard as Nails. When revealed, give the villain a tough status card. If you cannot, heal 3 damage from it instead. So we give villain a tough status card, and we also forgot to put a damage on Spider Woman, Spider Girl. So many new spiders. There's actually a new Spider Man in this deck too, so really liking this hero already. So that is the villain phase. We'll go next to the next hero phase. Let's see. So I think we're playing the piercing strike to get rid of the tough and hitting more. I'll play the piercing strike with contaminant immunity and combat training, because we don't have resources to play combat training this turn. So we remove the tough and we deal 3 damage. And we played an aspect card, so we get 1 boost there. I'll hit for 2 damage. I will play the self-propelled glide. So I ready Spider-Woman. And I'll hit for 2 again. And I think will advance Crossbones next turn, so I won't hit with Spider Girl. I think I'll defend with Spider Girl this turn, so we ready up and draw back up to 5. So we get combat training, interrogation room, attack team, press the advantage, and Venom Blast. So Venom Blast is looks as quite powerful card, and it also counts as an aggression card, so we could boost twice with interrogation room and play Venom Blast next turn. Okay, that's the hero phase. Let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. And Crossbones attacks, I won't defend. Crossbones hits for... Oh yeah. So, Crossbones hits for... If this card resolves during an undefended attack, discard a support you control. Well, we'll discard the skilled investigator. And we take 1 damage. And that's that. The encounter card is full auto. When revealed, hero. Discard X cards from the top of the encounter deck, where X is Crossbones attack. Take 1 direct damage for each boost icon discard this way. Well, Crossbones attack is 1. So we discard 1 card, and we hit 1 boost, so we take 1 damage. Okay, that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Let's see in here. I think I will use the tag team to play down interrogation room. We get 1 boost to our stuff. I'll hit with Spider Girl. We'll advance Crossbones to stage 2. So while Crossbones has a weapon attachment, it gains piercing when revealed. Search the encounter deck and discard pile for Crossbones machine gun and attach it to Crossbones shuffle the encounter deck. So we search for the machine gun. There it is, and we'll shuffle the encounter deck. Okay, Crossbones machine gun, plus 0 attack with a star. Attached to Crossbones, uses 2 ammo counters per investigator. I mean, per player. Playing too much Arkham lately. Post interrupt, when Crossbones attacks, you remove 1 ammo counter from this card and discard the top card of the counter deck. Take direct damage equal to the number of boost icons discarded. So I'll use these as ammo counters. And Crossbones has 14 health. Then I will play Venom Blast. We'll boost ourselves again. So, hero action attack, deal 5 damage to an enemy. So we deal 5 damage. Then we have a attack of 3, but we also have a thwart of... Okay, I think I'll thwart. And we'll flip. Let's see what's the next card. So. We will know that Crossbones won't thwart. Oh yeah, actually we will know that the act will advance, but what can you do? I think I need to go heal this turn, so I'll go to Alter Ego anyways, and we draw back up to 6. And this goes away. So we get another piercing strike, skillet investigator, heroic intuition, Jessica Drew's apartment, inconspicuous, and clear the area. Let's go to the villain place. We add one threat to the main scheme. Crossbone dwarf for 2 plus 1. So we advance this. So the act 2A is the main scheme 2A is the Infinity Stone. It has 6 threat threshold when revealed. Reveal the top card of the experimental weapon deck. So let's see what we get. So Crossbones gets the exosuit attached to the villain. Hero action, spend energy, mental and physical resources, discard this card, and it gives plus one shield and plus one attack. So I think we'll just try to burn down Crossbones as fast as possible. And then we get the encounter card for this turn. It's full auto. Because we're in alter ego, it just searches. And Crossbones armor attached to Crossbones. Forced interrupt when Crossbones would take any amount of damage, place it here instead. If there is 5 or more damage here, discard Crossbones armor. Just put it here. Okay, so that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So we still need to do 14 damage to Crossbones to get him defeated. Let's look at the top card of the encounter deck again. So it's an advance, so we know there's no big boost coming. Yeah, I think I'll heal. And I'll flip. Before I flip, I'll use clear the area to play inconspicuous. We'll play that Jessica Drew's apartment. So we exalt Jessica Drew's apartment. We search the top 5 cards of your deck for an aspect card and add it into your hand. Shuffle your deck. Let's see what we get. We could take the Venom Blast. Yeah, I'll take the Venom Blast as it counts as an aspect card. Unfortunately, we would have drawn Captain Marvel soon, but she gets shuffled into the deck again. And now we flip. Then we will Venom Blast. I'll use the Inconspicuous and Heroic Intuition to play it. We'll deal 5 damage, so we remove the armor. And I'll keep the Piercing Strike in hand. And I'll play the Skillet Investigator. And we played Aggression and Justice card, so we have plus 2 until the end of the round. We draw up to 5. We have Finesse, clear the area, attack team and strength. And we'll go to the villain phase. We add one threat here. Crossbones attacks. Crossbones attack is now 3. So for this turn, I think I'll defend with Spider-Woman. So we have a defense of 3, and the boost card is 0. And let's see, then we take no damage from the attack, but let's see. We remove one ammo counter from this card and discard the top card of the encounter deck. Take indirect damage equal to the number of boost attackers. So we get 1 indirect damage. And that is that. We'll get an encounter card, which is a Hydro Flame Soldier. Force response of the Hydro Flame Soldier makes an undefended attack against you. discard a support for two control. Okay, so that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. I think I'll use strength to play down Finesse. I'll exhaust Finesse and I use clear the area. And piercing strike to play down tag team. And we have played one aspect card. And the tag team comes in the play with three counters. And I think I'll just start hitting crossbones down. So that's our turn, we ready up. We get Captain Marvel, piercing strike, contaminated immunity, skilled investigator, press the advantage. The villain phase starts, we have one threat here, crossbone attacks. I won't defend this time. It has 3 attack plus 2, so 5. Okay, this is starting to hurt. And Hydra Flame Soldier attacks, so we have to discard a support we control, and I'll discard the interrogation room. Take 1 damage. And the encounter card for this turn is Crossbones Assault. So it has 2 threat per player and gives a boost icon. And when defeated, Crossbones activates against the player who defeated this shield. So I think we just try to kill off Crossbones as fast as possible. So that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. I would want to play Captain Marvel. So we have 2 damage. 2 from Captain Marvel, then I think we are playing only 1, so we have 2 from Spider-Woman, so we need 2 more. Yeah. Let's see if we can manage that. So we try to play Captain Marvel first. I'll spend to spend all of these. Play Captain Marvel. And Captain Marvel attacks for 2. And we draw a card with Captain Marvel's response. We get Spider-Man. Doesn't help us this turn. I'll deal 2 damage with this. And I'll just hit for 1, because next turn we can just tag team Crossbones away, so I'll flip to safety. And we draw up to 6. So we have a self-propelled glide, finesse, pheromones, heroic intuition, inconspicuous, and Spider-Man. And we go to the villain phase. We add one threat here. Actually, two threats because there's an acceleration token. Crossbones towards for 3+1. So we advance this. The getaway. When revealed, reveal the top card of the experimental weapons deck. If this stage is completed, players lose the game. So. Crossbones gains the laser rifle, so now when attached villain attacks, the attack gets ranged and we can remove it by spending an energy and a physical resource. So the flame soldier seems for one. Encounter card for this turn is weapon master. The villain seems if they have a weapon attachment, this card gains search. So they have a weapon attachment, so shaming for 3+4. Okay, so we just lost the game here. Well, that was unlucky. We would have won next turn, but it is what it is. I think I'll reset and try again. So what happened is Crossbones seems for 3+2 from the Hail Hydra that has two boost icons. So we thread out, and that's the game. Well, a decent blind try, but not quite able to finish Crossbones off for the first try. So I'll set up and try again, and we'll try to defeat him and continue to the next villain. So I'll be right back. Okay, so let's try this guy again. So the experimental weapons deck gives us energy shield again. We draw our hand of 6 cards. We get the prestige advantage, finesse, combat training, skilled investigator, and then imminent immunity and self-propelled glide. So we'll keep the finesse, we'll keep the combat training, we'll just play those. Let's discard the rest. Maybe we get some. Well, we get the Spider Girl. Piercing Strike. Skilled Investigator and Interrogation Room. Okay. Let's see what Crossbones does. So, two boost icons. So, we'll definitely play Spider Girl. I'll use the interrogation room. Oh yeah, and I'll flip before that, so I get the boost up. And I think we still play the finesse. So we hit for 2 damage and 2 damage. And now I forgot to retaliate, so let's not hit with the Spider Girl. Just hit it, Spider Woman. Okay, that's our turn. We're ready up. We get Presti Advantage, Venom Blast, Energy Inconspicuous, and Content in anti Immunity. Crossbone attacks. I think I could defend with for this turn. Oh yeah, there we had one threat here. So I'll defend. I have defense of 2. I forgot to reset that. So 1+2. We take one damage. Hang on, the card is full auto. Discard X cards. Yeah, so we discard one card. We get one boost icon, so we deal one. Is it indirect? Yeah, so we deal it to Spider Girl. Okay, and that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, so with Finesse we can generate a wild resource for an aspect card, so we'll use that definitely. So I'll press the advantage, I will deal 2 damage, and we get plus 1. Then we Venom Blast, we deal 5, and then I'll play the Inconspicuous to remove this and get a boost here, and we're ready up. We draw back up to 5. Oh yeah, and we hit twice, so we take 2 retaliates from Crossbones. So we get Tag Team, Finesse, Genius, clear the area, and Piercing Strike. Okay, villain phase, we had one threat here, Crossbones attacks, I'll defend with Spider Girl. Okay, so we get an encounter card, and it is Assault, so we'll defend. So we don't get anything from that, so that is that, so let's go to the next hero phase. We'll use Genius to play Finesse, so we have 2 Finesses in play. All these were removed again. I'll use both of the Finesses and clear the area to play Tag Team. And I'll use one counter from Tag Team to hit the villain, 2 damage. And I played one aspect card, so I get one here. I ready up. I'll draw back up to 5. We have Heroic Intuition, Piercing Strike, Inconspicuous, Venom Blast, and Piercing Strike. Okay, and we go to the villain phase. We had one threat here. Crossbones attacks. I will defend. We get 2 boost icons, so we take 1 damage. And counter card is Assault. And we take 2 damage. And that's the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. So, let's see. We can Venom Blast easily, then we can Piercing Strike easily. That's all we can play this turn. This goes away. So, yeah, let's see. I think we can get rid of the Energy Shield this turn. Somehow, maybe. No, we don't have a... Unfortunately, we don't have a mental resource at hand. So I think I'll use the Tag Team. I'll deal 2 damage. So we flip to phase 2. We search for the machine gun. And we add the health, and Crossbones has 14 health, which we need to deal with, and I think we'll play inconspicuous, so we get one here, remove those threats, then we will Venom Blast. And then we will flip to, yeah, we take one. Retaliate, we go to Alter Ego. Let's check the top card. Okay. So I think that's our turn. I'll keep the piercing strikes. We draw back up to 6, so we get Jessica's apartment, heroic intuition, skilled investigator, and clear the area. And we go to the villain phase, we add one threat here. Crossbone schemes, so we advance. So we reveal the top card from here. So, exosuit. And the encounter card is Crossbones Assault. Okay, so we really need to try to burn down Crossbones as fast as possible now. Okay, that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So I think we have to heal. But before that, I'll check the top card from here. So the villain would attack me twice. Do I want to take those attacks? We don't have an ally to play. We need 9 damage. So we have 2 here. We can boost Jessica to 3, so it's 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. I think we have it just enough to defeat Crossbones this turn. Okay, so we'll just flip. I'll play this, so I get 1 here. And okay, I'll play the piercing strike. We use these. We take one retaliate and deal 3. We get here this boost. And did I miscut? Oh dear. I'll deal 2 from here. We can remove the retaliate. Yeah, let's do that. I'll spend clear the area and heroic intuition before I actually do that before anything else. So let's get this back. Yeah. Okay, now we hit for 3 damage, and we can piercing strike to defeat Crossbones. Okay, well, yeah, this was removed. So, we managed to defeat Crossbones on our second try. So that is that, and because we're playing the campaign, I get to choose one of these tech cards. I will choose it before the next game, but yeah. That was Crossbones on standard difficulty in the campaign mode with Spider-Woman pre-built deck from the Rise of Red Skull expansion. Hope you guys like this game. I will play the Absorbing Man next, and I'll put it in this same video, so stay tuned for the Absorbing Man next. Okay, so we managed to beat the Crossbones villain, and now we are facing Absorbing Man in the Rise of Red Skull campaign mode. I already drew the environment at random from the encounter deck, so we got the abandoned facility, so it's a metal traded environment, and Absorbing Man has the metal trait. And we decided to pick emergency teleporter for Spider-Woman, so as a hero action we can discard this card and remove it from the campaign log. We can search our deck and discard pile for an ally and put it into play and give it a tough status card. So I think that will be really useful to get either Captain Marvel or Spider-Man into play. I am playing Absorbing Man on standard difficulty. I have not played it before, so let's see how this goes. Hopefully we can beat this a bit easier than the Crossbones, which proved to be quite okay, but we had a bit of bad luck in the first try and got skimmed out at the end. I'm using the pre-built deck for Spider-Woman, so I won't go into the deck list that much. So let's get started. Let's draw our opening hand. So I've pre-shuffled both of the decks. Get 6 cards. We get strength, pheromones, energy, heroic intuition, self-propelled glide, and clear the area. I think there's a bit too much sport stuff here, so I think I'll, because I have the double resources, I think I will play the pheromones. Then I will play heroic intuition. And actually, I could just I'd just keep this because I can play the self-propelled glide. Okay, so first I think we'll use Jessica Drew's ability and check the top card of the encounter deck. So it's a double boost icon. So because we are playing the pheromones, we know that we will get this Hydra regular into play, because Absorbing Man won't be attacking or thwarting. So let's just start playing. I'll flip Spider-Woman. I will play Heroic Intuition. So we'll mark again that we have a plus one. Then I will use pheromones with strength. So we stun and confuse an enemy. So we'll stun and confuse Absorbing Man. And I don't think the card draw for clear the area is not that important, so I think I'll just thwart for 2, and then I'll play self propelled glide and ready up, and because there's no threat to remove, I'll just hit for two. And that is our turn. So we ready up and draw back up to five. I think I won't use the emergency teleporter yet this turn, so we get Jessica Drew's apartment, genius, piercing strike, press the advantage, and inconspicuous, hard words to pronounce for me. Okay, let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. Absorbing Man tries to attack, but it's stunned, so we remove the stun. Encounter card is Hydra regular, and it has the new keyword inside one. So when this card is revealed, place one threat on the main sheet. So we add one threat there, and that's the villain phase. So let's go to the next hero phase. So let's see. I could play the inconspicuous to remove the threat. Oh yeah, this goes away. So I think I'll start by playing I'll play the piercing strike. So we gain this, and we'll hit Absorbing Man with the piercing strike, so we deal 3 damage and go through stun. I mean tough, but there's no tough, and yeah, I think I'll press the advantage and hit the Hydra regular. Then I will vote for 2 or 3 because of that, and I think I will flip, and let's check the top card. So we know that the next boost card will put this dense forest into play, so it searches, but it's a boost, so it doesn't search. So force response after Absorbing Man makes an undefended attack against you, take 1 indirect damage, 2 indirect damage if there are 5 or more delay counters on the main scheme. So we still don't have any delay counters, but force response after the resolving step of the villain phase, they place 1 delay counter here. Oh yeah, so we we should have 2 delay counters here. Okay, yeah, I missed that keyword at our post response. So we add a threat here, so we add the second one here, and yeah, let's put that back. So yeah, we're getting ahead of ourselves. So I forgot where I was, so I'll draw back up to 6 and ready up. Okay, so we have Captain Marvel, self-propelled glide, interrogation room, another self-propelled glide, and press the advantage, and the 6th card is Jessica Drew's apartment. Now we are ready to go to the villain phase. We add the threat, and we add another here. Absorbing Man doesn't dwarf because it's confused, and we get an encounter card, and yeah, it searches. So forced response, we have to change this, and it searches, and we get the Hydra soldier in play. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Let's see what we are getting for the boost card next turn. So we get another Hydra Soldier card, so it's boost of 1. Well, that's, I think, fine. And let's see. Yeah, this is removed again. I really would like to get Captain Marvel onto the table, but we have quite bad resources in hand. We could use the emergency teleporter, but I think this is not the right time. So I'll flip. And then I will play interrogation room, play an aspect card, then I will play press the advantage and hit the Hydra soldier for 2 damage. And I think we'll just play Jessica Drew's apartment with Captain Marvel. And yeah, let's hit this Hydra soldier. So we have the interrogation room. We can remove one threat from the machine. And we get one extra encounter card for this turn. Which will be a Hydra soldier. Okay. So I think we remove the emergency teleporter and put Captain Marvel into play, and she comes into play with Tough. I won't use her yet. But yeah, this is exhausted. So we ready up. We draw back up to 5. We get a piercing strike, clear the area, finesse attack team and clear the area. And we go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. Absorbing Man attacks. Captain Marvel will defend. And Absorbing Man hits for 2 plus. So we have to put this into play. And it's no hillside. Force response after Absorbing Man makes an undefended attack against you. Place 1 threat on the main shield. 2 threat if there are 5 or more delay counters. Okay. So we remove the Tough, and that's that. Encounter cards are the Hydra Soldier and Piercing Thorns. So when revealed, discard 1 card at random from your hand. If Absorbing Man has the wood trait, discard 1 card to control. Well, it's ice, so we just discard 1 card at random from our hand. Oh yeah, and we should have added 1 delay counter there. Let's see what we discard. So we lose 1 of the clear the area cards. That is totally fine. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see. We really need to get rid of that Hydra soldier again. I think I will. I really can't go to Alter Ego this turn. I'll get the finesse into play, which is a shame. Yeah, it is what it is. So let's play the. Let's just use clear the area, piercing strike, and finesse to play tag team. And we'll use tag team right away. We'll deal 2 damage to the Hydra soldier. And also, Spider Woman will hit for 2. So we get an extra encounter card. And that is our turn. We defeated 1 enemy, so we get to remove 1 threat. So we're ready up. And roll back up to 5. And we get a skilled investigator, piercing strike, venom blast, comp training, and skilled investigator. Okay. And so we add one threat to the main scheme. I think this turn I will defend with Spider Woman for the Absorbing Man attack, and it's 2 plus. Reveal this card. Super Absorbing Power. So it's a side scheme. Absorbing Man gains the Ice, Metal, Stone, and Wood traits. So it comes into play with 3 threat. Well, that's an interesting side scheme. Okay, we'll have to figure out how to get rid of that next turn. Possibly. Or turn after that. So we didn't take any damage. So that's fine. Encounter cards. First one is Court of Guard. Discard an upgrade or support you control. I think... yeah, I'll discard the Heroic Intuition. No, the Interrogation Room. Next one is Steel Kick. So, when revealed hero, take 3 indirect damage, 4 indirect damage if, instead if Absorbing Man has the Metal trait. So, actually, we forgot to add this again, I think. So, we take 4 because Absorbing Man has the Metal trait at the moment. I'll just take all of it on Spider-Woman. And I think that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, so we don't have quite enough to remove the super absorbing power unless we manage to get an answer by drawing a car with Captain Marvel. So I think I'll just start thwarting. So we remove 2 from here. And we draw a card with Captain Marvel's ability. So we get the press to advantage. That doesn't help us. I think I'll just upgrade my stuff this turn. So I'll play the... actually... I think I'll play the Venom Blast with Piercing Strike and Skilled Interrogator. So we get 1 here and we deal 5. And then we'll press the advantage. So we deal another 2. And we'll put this into play so we get boost to our defense. Be ready up. Oh, and I think I'll advance Absorbing Man to next stage 2. It might be risky, but let's see. So, Absorbing Man gains the trait of each environment in play. When revealed, its super absorbing power is in play. Deal 1 encounter card to each player. Otherwise, that's a... okay, well, actually, this was a good time to flip Absorbing Man, because now we only deal 1 encounter card and we don't get super absorbing power again with full threat on it. So we only need 15 more damage. So let's let's ready up. We draw back up to 5. We get Spider-Man, Heroic Intuition, Tag Team, Interrogation Room, and Contaminant Immunity. So we'll add a threat here, and we add 1 here. So we are at 5. So Absorbing Man attacks. I will defend. We'll take 2 plus. We get the ball and chain in play. So I think it adds now. So it's 3 damage, but we have a 3 defense. So we take no damage. And encounter cards. First one is Stall Tactics. Place one threat on the main scheme for every 2 delay counters on that. The main scheme. If no threat was placed this way, this game card can search. So we have 5, so it's 2 threat there. Next card is Avalanche. So when revealed, each player must choose to either spend an energy resource or take 2 indirect damage, 3 indirect damage if there are 5 or more delay counters. And it has 2. Okay, so we really need to start getting our dwarf cards. And let's see. I think I'm fine. I think I'm fine losing one because I really don't have enough to play Spider-Man. Or actually I do, because I think because I can get an extra card, so I'll just take the 3 indirect damage. Oh yeah, this should not be a 10, so yeah, we'll take the 3 like so. Yep, I had the token upside down, so but still it's fine. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So we'll thwart with Captain Marvel. Let's see here. Okay, so we get rid of. Yeah, there should be counter here. So we get rid of this. And we can trigger Skilled Investigator. So we exhaust Skilled Investigator and draw a card. We also draw a card with Captain Marvel. And then let's see here. I'll use the tag team, Heroic Intuition, Interrogation Room, Combat Training, and I think I'll hold on to Finesse. So we'll play Spider-Man. Just put it here. So after you play Spider-Man from your hand, remove 3 threat per investigator per player. From a side scheme, so we remove this one. And we played one card, and Spider-Man can thwart for 2. So we get the threat in check. And let's ready up. I think Captain Marvel will block the attack for this turn. We draw back up to 5. We are 2, 3, 4, 5. So, let's see. We add a threat to the main scheme. And we add a delay token here. Absorbing Man attacks, we'll defend with Captain Marvel. And Absorbing Man hits for 5. Captain Marvel is defeated. And counter card is Gang Up. So Absorbing Man attacks again. I think Spider-Man has to defend. We are too low in health. And good thing, because we would have taken like 3 damage. So yeah, Spider-Man is defeated. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. So yeah, this gets removed again. I think we'll play pheromones. I'll use. Let's think this again. I think I'll play pheromones. I'll use contaminant immunity. Actually, we could play the contaminant immunity and get the tough and heal 3 damage. I think I like the sound of that. So we'll use. I think I'll just try to rush down. So I'll play the Venom Blast. So I'll deal 5 damage. It's an aggression card, so I'll get one here. I will hit for 2. I will flip. I'll use the apartment, so we can set top 5 cards, but we only have 2, so we search and we'll get aspect card, and I'll use the pheromones and inconspicuous play spider girl who will hit for 2, and we'll just use the tag team, so we'll hit for another 2. Okay, so the absorbing man has 4 health remaining. Hopefully we can finish him off next turn, so we draw back up to 6. Okay, so we got the Venom Blast, so if we don't tread out and we don't get a guard minion or something like that, I think we're ready to win next turn. But let's see, we go to the villain phase, we add the threat here, we add a delay counter here, then absorbing man schemes for 2+3 and a boost. If absorbing man has the ice or metal, he has the ice, he gains tough status. So okay, so he for 2+2, so 4. We are at 8 of 12 threats, and counter cards are, first one is advance. Oh come on, 3. So we are at 11. God damn it! If I lose again. And omnimorph duplication when revealed. If absorbing hand. If absorbing man has the ice trait, exhaust your identity. Oh well, you're exhaust. And that is the villain phase. We are one away from threatening out. We have like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 of 12. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, so this was a close match. I'll just use the to draw aspect card. Yeah, we'll get the another piercing strike, why not? We'll flip. Spider girl removes the tough. And as a last action, we'll just play the Venom Blast to deal 5 damage to absorbing man and defeating absorbing man. So okay, that ended up being quite close. We were one threat away from scheming out, but luckily we managed to defeat absorbing man in time, and I feel absorbing man feels quite much easier than crossbones, and I think absorbing man would be a better starting villain for this campaign run, but it is what it is, and maybe on expert difficulty absorbing man gets a lot tougher, but at standard he feels quite easy. with the starting with the pre-built deck, at least. I think with deck build decks it will be a cakewalk, but yeah, I will determine what upgrade I will get for Spider Woman for the next villain, and the next villain will be in the next video Taskmaster, and I think I will do Taskmaster and Zola in the next video, so look forward to that. And after that we'll have the final video of this series, fighting against Red Skull. But this was Absorbing Man on standard difficulty in the campaign mode with Spider-Woman. Thanks for watching, and until next time.